Welcome to He Said,
She Said,
featuring Mobile Ecstasy and Nubian Queen. We're thinking of a topic, and I came up with one.
All right.
This topic is, what do you do when your significant other just shuts you down? Or when your significant other disrespects you, and or when your significant, actually it's just when your significant other just shuts you down and don't allow you
to give an opinion. Talk
or give an opinion, they just be like, blah, 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 pshoom, and you're like, what? Wait, hold up, and they're not even trying to hear it, right?
Ooh.
Yeah, what'd you think?
I
can tell you right now that I take offense to it, and I become very upset.
Yeah.
When someone just cuts me off and don't allow me to get my point across or express my thoughts or opinions.
Yeah.
Oh. Me
too. But do you think that that is a form of mental abuse? If you do it all the time, like if someone
it'd be like me just cutting you off and telling you no, you're wrong, and that's it.
And leaving it at that, and I'm like, what you mean?
No, we're not talking about it no more.
That's mental abuse.
I'm the man in this relationship. You need to just shut your mouth.
That's mental abuse. And I'm not going to be abused. That's mental abuse. I don't care how you look at it.
What do you do if your man like grabs you rough, like hard, and because he's trying to get his point across, you know, or he shakes you. Listen, woman, or like my buddy on that show we watched, because his wife cheated on him, gave him an STD.
Well, he choked her.
He thought about it. The whole world turned red in front of his eyes.
He didn't hear nothing.
He put them.
I couldn't.
Hand around the neck.
I couldn't deal with it. I would be very angry.
Have you ever been mentally abused?
Yes, I have.
Mm-hmm. What is it like being mentally abused? Like,
it's like you have no say. You're in a relationship with someone, but you have no say so on anything. And when you do think, like, when it's something that's really bothering you and you want to say something, you're like, if I say something, this is gonna escalate, so I'm not gonna say anything. So you don't say nothing.
Man.
You just leave it, and you're like, oh, it's okay. It's okay, or whatever. You just don't say nothing.
Build up the and anger, then they build up, and then
it's gonna be that one time that she just gonna snap, She just gonna go ham, and then you're gonna be standing there like,
how do you tolerate it? How do you allow someone else to talk to you in a disrespectful manner?
I don't know. It just happens.
It's like, what shows were we watching by Tyler Perry yesterday?
Why did I get married?
And she was like, whatever her name was, she was like, I'm so used to it, I just try to beat people to the punch of making fun of myself.
Right, so she talks about her weight all the time.
Yeah, so she talks about herself.
See, I wasn't like that.
How do you know?
I wasn't like that. I wasn't like that.
How do you know?
But I was like,
you was not talking about weight, but your focus may have been something totally else.
That
different.
Is true.
And I know what it was. I bet you don't remember.
What?
Okay, this individual always prevented you from what? Other than being happy, I mean, but
a lot of stuff.
How did he always invade your invade your space? How did he break you so many times by the words that he said? Every day when you've seen him, what did you expect to hear?
Complaints. Or just nagging or something. Just something being wrong.
Complaints.
Yes.
So when you started a new relationship, you was always worried whether or not you was not doing enough.
Right. If I was doing something right.
Exactly.
Or did I do something?
Right.
Okay, yeah. That's
and yeah, everyone, it takes a while to get out of stuff like that.
Yeah, I know.
But she, in his case, he always complained about her weight and her being overweight. So for her, her mechanism of coping was to talk about herself and her weight and how she didn't feel that anyone could believe she was beautiful.
Right.
And
because he tore down so much.
Exactly. She didn't even think she was beautiful. I remember there were clothes you couldn't even wear.
Yeah, a lot of clothes.
You wearing right now?
Yeah, right, exactly. Only thing I can wear is like scrubs. Like, I'll get you scrubs. I'll buy you scrubs, you know. It was like that. Mm-hmm. And it'd be no perfume.
And with
no.
Your freedom, you went and bought you some little shirts about this
I
big.
Did. They weren't. They were. No, they weren't.
Butt cheeks and everything.
Whatever.
You see the butt cheek hanging out under the shirts.
Yeah, I had to.
But I'm saying.
There's a lot of stuff in that that was just so wrong. So, yeah.
Yep. How do you get out of it, though?
You just have to.
How do you get out? I mean, if there is not someone there to support you getting out, how do you get out? Because you had.
I had support.
You had support.
But it's like I was already like to the point of like.
Yeah, you were already to the point.
Like I was like, you know.
You was about you.
I could hurt you right now.
Yeah.
So. I don't know.
Would you tell another woman?
Get out.
But they're thinking is how do I get out? I don't have no money. My family is not around. How do I plan this? How do I plan to get out of an abusive relationship without getting myself hurt?
Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta go. You can't stick around. You have to go.
And you know, men go through this same thing too. I am recently divorced. And everyone, abuse comes in all forms and fashions. Mm-hmm. I mean, you may not be physically abused, but you can be mentally abused, psychologically abused. If it's not the same as mentally abused, spiritually abused, you can have a mixture amongst all of them. But in my case, I received mental abuse, but it wasn't like someone that was talking crap to me and downing me every time. My mental abuse was brought on by myself. I created my own mental abuse. I did love my ex, and because I loved him, I did things that were stupid. And a lot of people do things that are stupid in the name of love.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you you do very stupid things. Very stupid things. So I was one of them. I've been married twice. My first, I was the one that ruined everything. I don't regret it. but I was the one that messed it up. I do regret hurting the individual, but I don't regret the results of it, which was a divorce. So my second marriage, I fell in love, and I said that this time, I'm not going to give up so easily.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what happened.
I said, I'm not going to be no punk. I'm going to try. I'm going to fight. Right? Mm-hmm. I'm going to fight, even if it means losing my children, mm-hmm. losing my house, losing everything that I worked so hard to get.
And you was going to fight.
Right.
Just because you said it.
And I almost lost everything. I prayed on it. And I don't pray on a lot of stuff. God will tell you. He's like, Welton, he don't pray that he needs a lot of stuff. But he does pray to give thanks a lot. But he don't pray needing much. That time I prayed. And I'm like, please, give me nobody. Or give me someone that's going to love me and that's going to be right for me. And the first thing that happened was my ex got, police ICE picked her up, unfortunately. They took her, you know, one of those little camps where they just hold people. And then they ended up deporting her, right? And the relationship was toxic. I wanted positive change. The other side was not able to give positive change. They were toxic. They have not reached a point in their life where they needed to make positive change. Mm-hmm. People are not going to change until they need to change, mm-hmm. want to change, or they don't change. That's true. Right? I realized that I needed to change like years before, but I wanted to fight for something that just wasn't going to work.
Yeah. Yep.
So, I'm not going to say God made everything happen, but what did happen eventually helped me find someone that was perfectly suited for me, for my personality, for the things that I want in life. I never, ever, ever experienced a relationship that was so effortless, where I did not have to work so hard to be happy. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a relationship when you don't have to work. You know, before I tell people, I'm like, look, man, you gotta work on your relationship. You gotta work. Right? You gotta wait. You gotta wait. But you know, the truth is the more you have, when you're compliant or compatible, the higher your compatibility is with your mate, whatever they are, the less work you're gonna have to put in to maintaining it. The less compatible, the more work you have to put into it to maintain the relationship. I'm just saying, if you having to struggle real hard for this relationship, then someone has to change to make it a little bit more effortless. Mm-hmm.
Or you gotta go. You can't.
But that's just my opinion. What does the queen have to say? I mean,
because I was the same way as far as with my last relationship. I was like, because normally I'd be out. Like, something happened, we not even finna stick around. But I was like, oh, I'm gonna fight. I'm not gonna give up so easy. And that's probably why I stayed with.
Whatever.
So long, you know, and took all that bad stuff. So I didn't want to give up so easy, but I was fighting for something that wasn't for me.
I think we've both been there.
And I'm like, hey, I gotta move on. I gotta go. If I don't, it would have been more years after that. I would have just continued on, and it just would have been horrible.
I couldn't have continued on.
See,
Well, actually, I probably would have if the police did not intervene. Mm-hmm. I would still be like, man, I hate my life.
Yeah. Yep. I would have continued. I would have been 2 years.
I don't want to go.
4 years. 4 years would have been 6 years. 6 years would have been eight. And then it would have been like.
I would have been like, damn. Is she going to kill me tonight?
Am I going to wake up? I didn't feel like that with my ex, though. I didn't feel like I could hurt you. I was just really, really angry. I was just so mad, but I wasn't like, I've been to the point of saying, I could hurt you. I could hurt someone, or the person I was with at the time. I was like, I could hurt him, and I remember calling my mom and was like, I gotta get up out of this.
You hear that, people?
I'm hurt him.
Leave your comments in the comments section and hit like or don't hit like.
And subscribe.
And real quick, see, going back today, somewhere in California, I believe, or was it Texas? California. A dude, he lost it. And he's like, man, life is not worth living. If my wife thinks she's going to do whatever, she's not doing nothing. I'm going to take her out and whoever else is around and then myself out. Don't let it get to that.
Just
walk away, man. Walk away. That's all you got to do.
Walking away is not that easy, though. Sometimes you walk away and you still end up.
As a man.
He was black, too.
What?
Out of me.
Yeah, I got no comment on that.
And you injured a child. And you go up to.
And they killed a child.
Eight-year-old.
Killed an 8-year-old, injured another child.
Trying to kill her.
And he was successful at killing her.
Well, I mean, not trying. He killed her and a child, and I'm like, did he kill himself?
Yes.
Yeah, okay, that was like the best thing for him, because...
No.
Not the best thing for him to kill himself.
Let me tell you why. Why him killing himself sucked. Mm-hmm. Because there was no way for the parents to get revenge.
See?
They're so angry.
They lost their kid.
And they wish they can kill that guy. He killed himself. You know how that just takes away the...
Let's go to court and fight.
Yeah.
What get justice for my kid.
Who can you go after?
Yeah. That's all I don't know.
I didn't even see if the children were black or not.
They had his picture, but the man was black and his wife was, I don't know.
See,
I don't think they can show us mine.
Come on, really, man. Just stop it. We got enough problems with, you know, with our image. We don't need to be adding more to our image.
And they were separated anyway. Only for like a month. What you say? Married a month? What happened? We don't know the details of the story, but...
Yeah, don't know the details.
If they... Something happened for them to be separated. What'd he do? Or she do?
And like the high twins...
He's so stupid.
This episode is over.